Welcome everybody. We are discussing the chapter Molecular Basis of Inheritance. So today we are going to discuss the second part of this chapter. And in this part, I will be discussing the DNA. Structure of DNA, chemical constituents, base pairing rule, salient features of double helix structure of DNA, and packaging of DNA. So, in our previous session, we have already discussed the search for genetic material, and we discussed two experiments, and by those experiments, it has been proved that the DNA is the genetic material. So, today in this session, we will be discussing about the DNA. Okay? So, let us see what will be the learning outcome of this session. At the end of this session, you will be able to draw the structure of DNA, explain the chemical composition of DNA, you can state complementary base pairing rule and solve problems related to it, and you can explain packaging of DNA, and at the end you can differentiate between DNA and RNA and explain why two strands of DNA run anti-parallel. So what we have studied so far? We have studied Frederick Griffith's experiment, Avery, MacLeod and McCarthy experiment, Alfred Harsey and Martha Chase experiment, and through all these experiments, we could know that the DNA is the genetic material. Now let us start the discussion. DNA, the molecule that carries genetic information. You have studied in class 10. Our blueprint, the blueprint of living cell or living body resides in the nucleic acid molecule. That is the DNA. Its full form is deoxyribonucleic acid. Okay. So, this in some cases the RNA or ribonucleic acid also expresses the blueprint. It carries the blueprint. Okay. So, the deoxyribonucleic acid, that is DNA, and ribonucleic acid, that is RNA, are the two types of nucleic acid found in living system. Okay, so in all body, all living body, both DNA and RNA are found. Okay, so except viruses in which either DNA or RNA is found. So what is DNA? DNA is a long polymer of deoxyribonucleotide. You know what is polymer? So when similar units are joined in the form of a chain, then that is called polymer. So this DNA is polymer of what? Deoxyribonucleotide. So the monomer of the DNA polymer is deoxyribonucleotide. Very, very important. Remember, the monomer of DNA polymer is deoxyribonucleotide. And the length of the DNA is expressed as number of nucleotides or base pairs. Okay, so usually the length is expressed either in terms of centimeter, meter. Okay, but here the length of the DNA is expressed as the number of nucleotides or base pairs. That means how many nucleotides form a DNA chain or DNA strand is the length of the DNA. Okay, and this length of DNA is very, very specific. That means in a particular species, the length of the DNA is specific. Okay, so for human being, the length of DNA is something. For cow, the length of DNA is something. For bacteria, the length of DNA is something. Okay, so it differ from species to species and it is very very specific for that particular species. So here I have given you some of the examples of DNA, that is how it varies and how it is very very specific in some species. So here you can see in virus, here we have taken one virus, that is bacteriophage 5-174. It is a virus that infects the bacteria, and its length of DNA in base pair, that means how many base pairs are present in the DNA or how many nucleotides are there, deoxyribonucleotides, yani uska jo monomer hai, kitna monomer present hai pair mein. It is always present in pair. So 5386. Okay, क्योंकि ये डबल स्टैंडर्ड है डीएनए, आगे जाएंगे तो हम उसके बारे में पढ़ेंगे. तो 5386 बेस पेयर. सिमिलरली अनदर वायरस बैक्टीरियोफेज लैम्डा, ये भी एक वायरस है जो कि बैक्टीरिया को इन्फेक्ट करता है. इसका लेंथ देखो, व्हाट इज इट्स लेंथ, 48502 बेस पेयर. ओके, देन बैक्टीरिया, हियर आई हैव गिवन Escherichia coli, that is E. coli. Here the length of the DNA is far more than that of virus. It is 4.6 into 10 to the power 6. Okay. Then human, Homo sapiens. Here the length of the DNA is 3.3 into 10 to the power 9. That means even longer than the bacteria. So, from this it is very much clear that it is how it is very very specific. The length of the DNA is very very specific for a particular species. Now, we will discuss the structure of DNA. As I told you that DNA is a polymer of deoxyribonucleotide. So, DNA is a nucleic acid made up of nucleotides joined into long strands or chain by covalent bond. Okay, that means एक DNA chain में बहुत सारे nucleotides होते हैं जो कि एक दूसरे से link होते हैं by covalent bond. And what is that covalent bond? I will tell you by showing the diagram. Okay, so these nucleic acids are long, slightly acidic macromolecules. न्यूक्लिक एसिड होता क्या है एंड व्हाई दे आर कॉल्ड न्यूक्लिक एसिड, बिकॉज दीज मॉलिक्यूल्स आर एसिडिक इन नेचर. दीज आर मैक्रो मॉलिक्यूल्स. यू नो व्हाट इज इन क्लास 11th, यू हैव स्टडीड व्हाट आर मैक्रो मॉलिक्यूल्स एंड व्हाट आर माइक्रो मॉलिक्यूल्स. ओके, एंड दे आर मेड अप ऑफ द स्मॉलर सब यूनिट्स कॉल्ड न्यूक्लियोटाइड्स व्हिच आर लिंक्ड टुगेदर टू फॉर्म ए लॉन्ग चेन. So why they are called nucleic acid? Because these substances or these molecules are acidic in nature, and for the first time they are identified in the nucleus. That's why the name nucleic acid. And these nucleic acids are, as I said, they are of two types, RNA and DNA. So the nucleotides are made up of three basic components. Now what is the monomer of DNA polymer? DNA या RNA जो भी है वो किसका पॉलीमर है? न्यूक्लियोटाइड का. न्यूक्लियोटाइड इज मेड अप ऑफ थ्री बेसिक कंपोनेंट्स. तीन बेसिक कंपोनेंट होते हैं. फर्स्ट इज ए 5-carbon sugar. सो सिंस 5-carbon प्रेजेंट है इस सुगर में, सो इट इज नोन एज पेंटोज सुगर. एंड इफ इट इज DNA, अगर ये DNA है तो उस सुगर को कहा जाता है डीऑक्सी राइबोज सुगर. व्हाई? आई विल टेल यू इन द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड. अगर ये आरएनए है तो इसको कहा जाता है राइबोज सुगर. सो व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन डीऑक्सी राइबोज सुगर एंड राइबोज सुगर? डीऑक्सी राइबोज सुगर मीन्स एब्सेंस ऑफ वन ऑक्सीजन. दैट मीन्स this is also a ribose sugar in which one oxygen is absent. But in which position? I will show you. But in RNA, the ribose sugar is present. which is a 5-carbon sugar. So both deoxyribose sugar and ribose sugar are 5-carbon sugar. Then what is the next component? The next component is phosphate group. And the third most important component is the nitrogenous base. Okay. So let us see what are the nitrogenous base. So these are the compounds that mainly contains the nitrogen. So these nitrogenous bases are of two types, purines and pyrimidines. Okay. So what are the differences between purines and pyrimidines? In class 11th you have studied about this, but still let me just revise that one. Purines consist of a 6-membered and a 5-membered nitrogen containing ring fused together. Okay. So purine mein, it is a double ring structure. Do ring hai isme, which are fused together, out of which one is 5-membered. Yahan aapka 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5-membered ring. Other one is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6-membered ring. So it is the fusion of a 6-membered and a 5-membered ring. Okay. So the purines are adenine and guanine. So here I have given the structure of adenine. In contrary, what are pyrimidines? Pyrimidines are single ringed structure. So here you see two rings are there in purine, but in pyrimidine a single ring structure. But this single ring structure is a 6-membered nitrogen containing ring. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 hexagonal structure is there. And what are the pyrimidines? The pyrimidines are thiamine, cytosine and uracil. So in DNA, the purines are adenine and guanine. Pyrimidines are thiamine and cytosine. But in RNA, the purines are adenine and guanine, same, okay, as that of DNA. But pyrimidines are different. So the pyrimidines are cytosine and uracil. So there is no thiamine in RNA. And in DNA, there is no uracil. So here, you can see the structure of nucleotide. And in a nucleotide, the bonds are very, very important. That that is more often asked in the exam as 1-mark question. So this is the sugar. So what are the three components I told you? The sugar, a 5-carbon sugar. Okay, 5-membered sugar. So this is the pentose sugar, jisme 5-carbon atom hote hain. Theek hai? Or this sugar is called pentose sugar, and in DNA it is called deoxyribose sugar. Okay, but in RNA it is called ribose sugar. What is the other component? Phosphorus. A phosphate group is there. Okay, and what is the third component? That is nitrogenous base. Jaise maine aapko bataya, purine or pyrimidine. So this can be purine or pyrimidine. Now, how these three are linked? So, at the center, the sugar is present. And this is the first carbon atom of the sugar, second carbon atom, third carbon atom, fourth carbon atom. And then here is the fifth carbon atom. Here, one more carbon atom is projected out. That is the fifth carbon atom. Now, so how they are joined together? So to the first carbon atom, the nitrogenous base is attached by a linkage or by a bond that is called N-glycosidic linkage. Very, very important. The nitrogenous base is attached to the first carbon atom of the deoxyribose sugar or the ribose sugar by N-glycosidic linkage. Okay. Similarly, to the fifth carbon atom, the phosphate group is attached by a linkage known as phosphoester linkage. Phosphoester linkage. So this is how the three components of the nucleotide are united or linked. Okay. Now, so this is the linkage between the two strands. You already know that DNA is a double-stranded structure, helical structure. So here, this is one strand of DNA. This is another strand of DNA. Okay. So from this structure, you have to learn many things. So listen to me very carefully and see this diagram carefully. Okay. So here, see, this is one nucleotide. Okay. This is one nucleotide which consists of a deoxyribose sugar, a phosphate and a nitrogenous base. So here T means thiamine. Okay. So similarly, this is another nucleotide. This is another nucleotide. This is another nucleotide. So here in one strand, how many nucleotides are there? There are together four nucleotides are there. Now see, look at this strand. In this strand, this is one nucleotide. From here, another nucleotide. From here, another nucleotide. And from here, another nucleotide. So in this strand also, four nucleotides are there. So now, I'll ask you, what is the length of this stretch of DNA? Ye DNA ka jo stretch hai, chota sa segment hai, iska length kitna hoga? Kitna batayenge aap, agar aapko pucha jayegi, what is the length of this DNA? It is 4 base pair. Kitna base pair hai? Ye base pair hai. Ye base hai, 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 ye base hai. To ye ek ek pair hai base ka. तो कितने पेयर है? 1, 2, 3, 4. सो द लेंथ ऑफ द डीएनए इज 4 बेस पेयर. आई थिंक इट इज क्लियर टू यू हाउ टू फाइंड आउट द लेंथ ऑफ द डीएनए. ओके, सो इट इज इन द टर्म्स ऑफ बेस पेयर्स. ओके, नाउ द न्यूक्लियोटाइड्स. दिस इज वन न्यूक्लियोटाइड एंड दिस इज अनदर न्यूक्लियोटाइड. सो इट्स So, in this strand, it starts from the sugar and ends with phosphate. But here, it starts with phosphate and ends with sugar. Why it is so? I will tell you. So, here you can see the two consecutive nucleotides, successive nucleotides, A nucleotide or A nucleotide, how they are joined. See? इन बिटवीन दिस टू न्यूक्लियोटाइड, ये दोनों न्यूक्लियोटाइड के बीच एक फॉस्फेट है और इसका दोनों तरफ एक ईस्टर बॉन्ड होता है. इसके दोनों तरफ ईस्टर बॉन्ड होता है. सो दैट्स व्हाई दिस बॉन्ड इज कॉल्ड फॉस्फोडाईस्टर बॉन्ड. कुड यू फॉलो? द टू सक्सेसिव न्यूक्लियोटाइड इन ए स्ट्रैंड ऑफ डीएनए are joined by phosphodiester bond. Okay. But the two base pairs of two different strand, दो strand के बीच में जो base pair में जो bonding होता है, linkage होता है, that is the hydrogen bond. Remember, it is a hydrogen bond. Okay. Between adenine and thymine, there are two hydrogen bond. Between guanine and cytosine, there are three hydrogen bond. This is very, very important. These are the base pairs. Between the base of two different strand of the DNA, the hydrogen bonds are present. So how many bonds we discussed here? In between two strand, between the nitrogenous base, hydrogen bonds. To the sugar, the base is attached by N-glycosidic linkage. To the sugar, to the fifth carbon of the sugar, the phosphate is attached by ester bond. Okay? So here also it is attached to the other nucleotide by ester bond. So a phosphate group is flanked by two ester bond. इस तरफ एक ester bond है, इस तरफ एक ester bond है. So this bond by which two successive nucleotides are joined or linked is called phosphodiester bond. Okay. Now you can see that these two strands are in opposite direction. आप यहाँ clearly देख सकते हो कि ये स्ट्रैंड में फॉस्फेट इस तरफ है और इस स्ट्रैंड में फॉस्फेट इज ऑन द राइट साइड. यहाँ लेफ्ट साइड में है, यहाँ राइट साइड में है. यहाँ आप सुगर को राइट साइड में देख सकते हो, यहाँ सुगर को लेफ्ट साइड में देख सकते हो. एंड हियर यू कैन ऑल्सो सी दैट इट इज रिटन एज 5' to 3' और यहाँ लिखा है 3' to 5'. ऐसा क्यों है? व्हाट डज इट मीन? इसका मतलब क्या है? आप देखो, यहां मैं आपको इस स्ट्रैंड में पहले बताती हूं, ये है आपका सुगर, ठीक है. सुगर का जो ये हो गया फर्स्ट कार्बन एटम, फाइव ऑफ फर्स्ट कार्बन एटम में आपका नाइट्रोजनस बेस अटैच होता है, देन सेकेंड कार्बन एटम, देन थर्ड कार्बन एटम. तो ये डीएनए अगर यहां खत्म होता है तो ये थर्ड कार्बन एटम जो सुगर का है यहाँ खत्म होता है तो थ्री कार्बन एटम इज फ्री. यहाँ ओ है, यहाँ पर और कोई न्यूक्लियोटाइड अटैच नहीं है. सो थ्री प्राइम एंड इज फ्री. सो दैट्स व्हाई दिस एंड इज कॉल्ड थ्री प्राइम एंड. अभी फिफ्थ कार्बन एटम में आपका फॉस्फेट अटैच है. ये फॉस्फेट किसके साथ अटैच्ड है? इट इज अटैच्ड विथ द थर्ड कार्बन एटम, ओ एच ग्रुप ऑफ थर्ड कार्बन एटम, इसके साथ अटैच्ड है. यहाँ पर भी आपका ये OH ग्रुप है, यहाँ पर भी इसका OH ग्रुप है, ठीक है. तो उसके साथ ये अटैच्ड है. तो यहाँ पर थ्री पोजीशन जो है वो ओपन नहीं है, ठीक. उसी तरह आप देख सकते हो फिफ्थ कार्बन एटम में जो फॉस्फेट है उसके साथ थर्ड कार्बन एटम का जो OH ग्रुप है वो अटैच हो रहा है, ठीक है, इन दिस वे. नाउ एट दिस एंड व्हाट विल सी कि इसका जो फॉस्फेट है, ये फॉस्फेट किसके साथ अटैच होना था? थ्री OH ऑफ द नेक्स्ट न्यूक्लियोटाइड, बट यहाँ कोई न्यूक्लियोटाइड नहीं है बिकॉज दिस डीएनए एंड्स हियर. सो दैट्स व्हाई फॉस्फेट व्हिच इज अटैच टू द फिफ्थ कार्बन एटम इज फ्री. सो हियर द थर्ड कार्बन एटम टू व्हिच OH ग्रुप इज अटैच इज फ्री, एंड हियर द फिफ्थ कार्बन एटम टू व्हिच फॉस्फेट इज अटैच इज फ्री. So that's why it is 3 prime end, this is 5 prime end. But in this strand, it is just opposite. आप यहाँ देख सकते हो, the sugars are in opposite direction, the nucleotides are in opposite direction. So that's why this is the 3 prime end and this is the 5 prime end. So these two are anti-parallel to each other. दोनों parallel है, but in opposite direction. That's why they are known as anti-parallel. Okay, so Why it is so? ऐसे क्यों है? Opposite direction में है. अगर ये opposite direction में नहीं होता, same direction में होता, तो क्या होता? ये जो base है, ये base इसका भी इस तरफ होता और इसका इस तरफ होता, तब bonding ये दोनों में नहीं हो सकता, ठीक है. तो that's why, because of this bonding, they are anti-parallel and they are named as 5' to 3', and the other strand is 3' to 5'. So this diagram often comes in your exam to show the phosphodiester bond and how the nucleotides are joined with one another. Okay. Now, every DNA and RNA molecule has an intrinsic directionality. As I said you, कि हम आपको कोई हम जैसे बोल दिए कि DNA में जो सीक्वेंस है, बेस का सीक्वेंस है, हम तो डीएनए का लेंथ बेस के हिसाब से पढ़ेंगे, तो बेस का जो सीक्वेंस है उसको बोलेंगे कि GTAACT. इसका मतलब क्या है? इसका मतलब इट इज अंडरस्टूड दैट इट इज फ्रॉम 5' to 3' डायरेक्शन. मतलब ये यहाँ पर फॉस्फेट ग्रुप है, यहाँ पर आपका 3' एंड का जो OH ग्रुप है, ठीक है. आप यहाँ क्लियरली देख सकते हो दो न्यूक्लियोटाइड हाउ दे आर अटैच्ड. ये देखो फर्स्ट कार्बन एटम, सेकेंड कार्बन एटम, थर्ड कार्बन एटम का जो OH ग्रुप था, और यहाँ जो फिफ्थ कार्बन एटम का, दिस इज फिफ्थ कार्बन एटम, का ओ एच ग्रुप था, अभी ये दोनों फॉस्फेट के दोनों तरफ ईस्टर, ईस्टर मतलब ओ, ओ लिंक्ड बाय ओ, सो दिस इज ईस्टर बॉन्ड, दिस इज ईस्टर बॉन्ड एंड दिस इज द फॉस्फेट ग्रुप. सो दिस स्ट्रक्चर और दिस बॉन्ड इज कॉल्ड फॉस्फोडाइस्टर बॉन्ड. ओके, सो दिस इज हाउ द फॉस्फोडाइस्टर बॉन्ड इज फॉर्म्ड बिटवीन द टू स्ट्रैंड्स ऑफ आई मीन टू न्यूक्लियोटाइड्स, सक्सेसिव न्यूक्लियोटाइड्स. ओके, नाउ चार्कोव्स ऑब्जर्वेशन इन डबल स्ट्रैंडेड डीएनए. चार्कोव ऑब्जर्व्ड दैट इन, ही स्टडीड मेनी डीएनए एंड ही ऑब्जर्व्ड दैट द प्रोपोर्शन ऑफ ए इज ऑलवेज इक्वल टू दैट ऑफ टी. मतलब जितना ए होता है एक डीएनए में उतना टी होता है. ओके, एंड जितना जी होता है उतना सी होता है. दैट मीन्स ए इज इक्वल टू टी एंड जी इज इक्वल टू सी. और दूसरा ऑब्जर्वेशन क्या था, इट फॉलोज दैट देर इज ऑलवेज एन इक्वल प्रोपोर्शन ऑफ प्यूरिन ए एंड जी. प्यूरिन क्या था आपका, एडेनिन एंड ग्वानिन. पिरिमिडिन क्या था, साइटोसिन एंड थायमिन इन डीएनए. तो इक्वल प्रोपोर्शन ऑफ प्यूरिन एंड पिरिमिडिन होता है. दैट मीन्स हम अगर ए प्लस जी एंड सी प्लस टी का रेशियो लेंगे तो इट इज ऑलवेज वन. ओके, सो दिस इज कॉल्ड चार्गव्स रूल. इट कम्स एज योर 2 marks क्वेश्चन. व्हाट इज चार्गव्स रूल, मेंशन द ऑब्जर्वेशन ऑफ चार्गव. ओके, नाउ द डीएनए हू स्टडीड द 3D स्ट्रक्चर, इट वॉज स्टडीड बाय फ्रैंकलिन, रोजालिन फ्रैंकलिन, who carried out an X-ray diffraction analysis of DNA. Okay, and he found out the structure is like this. Okay, so X-ray diffraction से इस तरह का structure उनको मिला था और जिससे उन्होंने ये structure को conclude किया. Now, this is the structure, double helical structure of DNA. Here also you have to learn many things. Okay, so these are the 2 strands of DNA. This is 1 strand, this is other strand. The 2 strands are anti-parallel, as I said. And this DNA, most of the DNA form the right-handed helix. मतलब ये right की तरफ turn हुआ है. ठीक है? You can see this turn of DNA is towards the right. Okay? It is a right-handed helix, remember, very, very important. The distance between 2 strands of DNA is 20 armstrong or 2 nanometer. Remember, 2 nanometer or 20 armstrong. Okay? And it maintains almost uniform distance throughout the DNA. Throughout the DNA, almost uniform distance, that is 20 armstrong or 2 nanometer. Now, as I said, the DNA length is expressed in terms of base pair. Okay? So here, the DNA forms a turn. This is 1 turn of DNA. 1 turn means what? This is half of circle. This is half of circle. Together, they will form a circle. Okay? So, the 2 coil that forms a सिंगल सर्कल इज कॉल्ड ए कंप्लीट टर्न. तो यहां से देखो, यहां से शुरू करेंगे ये इसका, ये जो रेड कलर दिखाई, रेड कलर वाला स्ट्रैंड है, तो यहां से शुरू करेंगे तो यहां तक लेंगे तो इट विल बी ए सर्कल. ठीक है, तो दिस इज कंसिडर्ड एज ए टर्न. सो 1 कंप्लीट टर्न का जो लेंथ है इट इज 3.4 नैनोमीटर. 3.4 नैनोमीटर. ओके, ये 3.4 नैनोमीटर में हाउ मेनी बेस पेयर्स आर देयर, कितना बेस पेयर है, 10 बेस पेयर्स. रिमेंबर, इट इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, इन वन टर्न इज 3.4 नैनोमीटर एंड इन ईच टर्न 10 बेस पेयर्स आर देयर. देन व्हाट विल बी द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन 2 सक्सेसिव बेस पेयर, 2 बेस पेयर के बीच क्या डिस्टेंस होगा, obviously it is 3.4 nanometer divided by 10. So it comes 0.34 nanometer or 3.4 angstrom. Okay. So this is the axis of DNA. And one more thing you should remember. The backbone of the DNA. DNA strand. Ye strand hai. Ye strand ka jo backbone hai. It is made up of sugar phosphate. Sugar or phosphate se ye backbone bana hua hai. And what is projected inward? The nitrogenous base is projected inward. So, it's very very important. The backbone is made up of sugar phosphate. Okay, it is called sugar phosphate backbone. Okay, and the nitrogenous bases are projected inward. So, in this strand also same. Okay. Now, Watson and Crick model of DNA. So, this double helical structure of DNA was first discovered by Watson and Crick. So, this is the model. So, agar isko hum khol dete hain, toh the structure is like this. That means, if one strand is in 5 prime to 3 prime direction, the other strand is in 5 prime to 3 prime direction. And this is the backbone, which is formed by the sugar phosphate. And these are the nitrogenous bases, which are hanging inward. So, these are the salient feature of the double helix of DNA. Already I have described it. So, it consists of two polynucleotide chains. The backbone is made up of sugar phosphate. The base project inside. Two strands are antiparallel. Adenine always pairs with thymine with two hydrogen bond. Guanine always pairs with cytosine with three hydrogen bond. And two chains are coiled in right-handed fashion. The pitch means each turn is 3.4 nanometer. The distance between consecutive base pair is 0.34 nanometer. And the distance between the two strand is 2 nanometer or 20 angstrom, which I have already discussed in the diagram, in the previous diagram. So, here you make a note that 1 nanometer is equal to 1 into 10 to the power minus 9 meter. Now, next, see, in human being, what is the length of DNA we studied? DNA ka length hum kitna dekhe? It is 3 in each strand is having 3.3 into 10 to the power 9 base pair. Okay. So, how long is this DNA? But how it is packaged in the nucleus of such a microscopic small cell? Is not it a wonder? So, now we'll discuss how this DNA, such a long DNA, is packaged within the small nucleus of the cell. The length of DNA double helix is about 2.2 meter. Agar hum meter mein calculate karenge toh. So, how it comes? 6.6 into 10 to the power 9. This is 2 to the power 9 base pair. It is not 109. It is 10 to the power 9 base pair into 0.34 into 10 to the power 9 meter per that is base pair. Okay. So, this is the in meter, it is the length of the DNA, and this is the in terms of a base pair. So, therefore, it needs a very very special packaging in the cell. So, in prokaryote, there is no nucleus, nuclear membrane is not there, and only one DNA is present. Okay, then how it is packaged? The packaging is very simple in case of prokaryote, which do not have a definite nucleus, like in a bacteria, in blue-green algae. The DNA is negatively charged and is held with some proteins that have positive charges in a region called nucleoids. So, bacteria mein, aap class 9th mein padhe ho, ki uska jis region mein DNA hota hai, us region ko kaha jata hai nucleoid. So, the DNA is negatively charged and it is packaged with the help of a positively charged proteins. Okay. And the DNA in nucleoid is organized in large loops held by the protein. Now, the packaging of DNA in eukaryote is very, very complex and important also. In eukaryotes, there is a set of positively charged protein called histones that are rich in basic amino acid residues, lysine and arginine. So, these in eukaryote also, the DNA is packaged with a protein, with the help of protein. And DNA is negatively charged, so definitely the proteins would be positively charged. And why this protein is positively charged? What is that protein? That protein is histone, and it is positively charged due to the presence of positively charged amino acid, that is lysine and arginine, in large number. Okay, so these histones, actually the histone protein consists of 8 molecules called histone octamer. Okay, then this DNA, the negatively charged DNA, is wrapped around the positively charged histone octamer to form a structure called nucleosome. और एक न्यूक्लियोसोम में आपका 200 बेस पेयर लेंथ का डीएनए हेलिक्स रैप होता है, ठीक है? एंड न्यूक्लियोसोम कंस्टिट्यूट द रिपीटिंग यूनिट ऑफ ए स्ट्रक्चर इन न्यूक्लियस कॉल्ड क्रोमाटिन. सो क्रोमाटिन, यू नो, व्हेन द सेल इज नॉट डिवाइडिंग, द क्रोमाटिन, द थ्रेड लाइक स्ट्रक्चर्स आर फाउंड, दैट इज कॉल्ड क्रोमाटिन. बट एट द टाइम ऑफ cell division, during metaphase stage, these structures, the nucleosomes, are condensed. They come closer to each other. Okay, they are come closer to each other and they are called chromosomes. Okay, now the packaging of chromatin at higher level requires additional set of proteins which are collectively called non-histone chromosomal proteins. So now let me show you the diagram and explain. So as I told you that the DNA, this is the DNA, and this part of DNA which is wrapped around the histone protein, the spherical structure is the histone protein, which consists of 8 subunits. Okay, and the DNA is wrapped around it, and this stretch of DNA which is wrapped around this protein is of 200 base pair. Okay, so this is histone octamer, and this is the core of the histone, this is core of the histone, and the DNA stretch of 200 base pair, and this is H1 histone, one subunit of the histone protein. Now together they form the nucleosome. So this beaded structure is nucleosome. Now this DNA, again it will form another nucleosome. This will form another nucleosome. So in this way, a number of nucleosomes are there and the DNA is packaged. Okay. So from the exam point of view, the diagram of nucleosome, as well as how the nucleosome is formed or how the DNA is packaged in the form of nucleosome, is also important. Now, another important part we should know is the heterochromatin and euchromatin. अब हम आपको बताएं कि chromatin क्या होता है? When the cell is not dividing, the thread-like structures present in the nucleus are called chromatin. But at the time of cell division, the compaction of the chromatin takes place, or they condense to form the chromosome, which is visible under microscope. But this chromatin, which is the thread-like structure, is of two types. So that is euchromatin and heterochromatin. In a single DNA, in each chromosome, one DNA is present, and in each DNA, there is a euchromatic region and heterochromatic region. Okay, so what is euchromatic region? Euchromatin is the less condensed region of the chromosome. Chromosome mein ye less condensed. Jo chromatin jab condense ho jata hai, tab ye chromosome banta hai. तो जहां पर आपका क्रोमोजोम का जिस हिस्से में ज्यादा कंडेंस हो जाता है, कम कंडेंस होता है, उसको कहा जाता है यूक्रोमाटिक। इसका मतलब क्या है? आपका जो न्यूक्लियोसोम है, न्यूक्लियोसोम यहाँ पर थोड़ा डिस्टेंट में प्रेजेंट होता है। आई विल शो यू द डायग्राम, ओके। और ये ट्रांसक्रिप्शनली एक्टिव होते हैं, दैट मींस दे कैन सिंथेसाइज द आरएनए। यू नो दैट डीएनए कैन सिंथेसाइज आरएनए, आरएनए कैन सिंथेसाइज प्रोटीन, सो दे कैन अंडरगो ट्रांसक्रिप्शन। सो दिस इज द पार्ट दैट इज ट्रांसक्रिप्शनली एक्टिव, ओके। नाउ हेटेरोक्रोमाटिन, सो दिस इज द टाइटली कॉम्पैक्टेड रीजन ऑफ द क्रोमोसोम। सो क्रोमोसोम का जिस पार्ट में, जिस हिस्से में आपका, जैसे सेंट्रोमियर या फिर टेलोमियर पर क्या होता है, बहुत सारे न्यूक्लियोसोम पास पास होते हैं, बहुत कॉम्पैक्टली अरेंज्ड होते हैं, तो उसको कहा जाता है हेटेरोक्रोमाटिन। तो जिसके वजह से डीएनए कैन नॉट बी एक्सपोज्ड, डीएनए आसानी से ट्रांसक्रिप्शन नहीं कर सकता, सो दैट पार्ट इज ट्रांसक्रिप्शनली इनएक्टिव। तो नाउ यू सी दिस डायग्राम, ये क्रोमोसोम है, तो जब सेल डिवीजन नहीं कर रहा है, सेल डिवीजन जब नहीं करता तो ये स्ट्रक्चर ऐसे होता है, ठीक है, जिसको जिसको कहा जाता है क्रोमाटीन, क्रोमाटीन फाइबर। तो जब क्रोमोजोम बन जाता है तब ये कॉम्पैक्ट हो जाता है, जैसे ये यहाँ पर ये कॉइल हुआ है, कॉम्पैक्ट हो जाता है और क्रोमोजोम में पैक हो जाता है। तो यहाँ आप डीएनए, आप देखो, आप क्रोमोजोम को हम खोल के देखेंगे, उसका जो डीएनए है, एक क्रोमोजोम में एक ही डीएनए होता है, मैंने बताया आपको। तो यहाँ पर आप देख सकते हैं कि जो हेटेरोक्रोमाटिन रीजन है, वहां पर जो आपका न्यूक्लियोसोम है कितना नजदीक है। सो दिस डीएनए, इसके चारों तरफ जो डीएनए रैप हुआ है, दैट डीएनए कैन नॉट सिंथेसाइज द आरएनए, सो दे आर ट्रांसक्रिप्शनली इनएक्टिव। बट यहां पर आप देखो न्यूक्लियोसोम्स, हाउ दे आर, ये न्यूक्लियोसोम, ये दो स्ट्रैंड है डीएनए का, ये एक स्ट्रैंड है, तो दोनों स्ट्रैंड में डीएनए किस तरह आपका दैट इज डिस्टेंटली प्लेस्ड, तो जिसके वजह से आपका डीएनए इजीली इट कैन ट्रांसक्राइब द आरएनए, सो दे आर ट्रांसक्रिप्शनली एक्टिव। नाउ प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ जेनेटिक मटेरियल, एक मटेरियल को जेनेटिक मटेरियल होने के लिए कुछ प्रॉपर्टीज होना चाहिए। सो व्हाट आर दिस क्राइटेरिया शुड बी फुलफिल्ड बाय दिस जेनेटिक मटेरियल? इट शुड बी एबल टू रेप्लीकेट, रेप्लीकेट मीन्स दे शुड हैव कैपेसिटी टू फॉर्म देयर ओन कॉपी, ओन रेप्लिका और डुप्लीकेट कॉपी। सेकेंड, इट शुड बी केमिकली एंड स्ट्रक्चरली स्टेबल, स्टेबल होना चाहिए, ऐसा नहीं कि आपका थोड़ा सा कुछ चेंज हो गया, क्लाइमेटिक चेंज हो गया या फिर एनवायरनमेंट में कुछ चेंज हो गया, सेल का एनवायरनमेंट में, तो इट विल रिएक्ट, इट विल बी रिएक्टिव, ऐसा नहीं होना है, इट शुड बी स्टेबल। थर्ड, इट प्रोवाइड्स द स्कोप फॉर म्यूटेशन, इसमें स्लो म्यूटेशन होना चाहिए, क्योंकि म्यूटेशन इज रिक्वायर्ड फॉर इवोल्यूशन। तो अगर म्यूटेशन नहीं हो रहा है जेनेटिक मटेरियल में, तो इवोल्यूशन ऑर्गेनिज्म का नहीं होगा। फोर्थ वन, इट शुड बी एबल टू एक्सप्रेस इटसेल्फ इन द फॉर्म ऑफ मेंडेलियन कैरेक्टर, मेंडेलियन कैरेक्टर जैसे फिनोटाइप, फिनोटाइपिक कैरेक्टर में एक्सप्रेस होता है, जैसे कोई कैरेक्टर को एक्सप्रेस कर रहा है, सो दैट मटेरियल शुड हैव दैट एबिलिटी टू एक्सप्रेस एज मेंडेलियन कैरेक्टर। बट दीज, ऑल दीज क्राइटेरियाज आर फुलफिल्ड बाय डीएनए एंड आरएनए, बट टू डिफरेंट एक्सटेंट, ओके। सो इट वॉज एस्टेब्लिश्ड बाय हर्शिज़ एक्सपेरिमेंट एंड मैकलियोड मैकर्टी एंड ओटी एवरी एक्सपेरिमेंट, दैट डीएनए इज द जेनेटिक मटेरियल, बट इन सम वायरसेस आरएनए वॉज ऑल्सो रिपोर्टेड एज जेनेटिक मटेरियल, लाइक टोबैको मोजेक वायरस, क्यूबी बैक्टीरियोफेज एटसेट्रा। सो हाउ बोथ डीएनए एंड आरएनए कैन बी जेनेटिक मटेरियल, ओके। सो अकॉर्डिंग टू द फोर क्राइटेरियाज आई हैव गिवेन, सो व्हाट इज द फर्स्ट क्राइटेरिया? डुप्लीकेशन, दिस शुड हैव कैपेसिटी टू रेप्लीकेट। बोथ डीएनए एंड आरएनए हैव द एबिलिटी टू डुप्लीकेट और रेप्लीकेट, सो द फर्स्ट क्राइटेरिया इज फुलफिल्ड बाय बोथ आरएनए एंड डीएनए। Second criteria is stability. If you compare the stability of DNA and RNA, then DNA is more stable than RNA. Okay, and why it is so? Because DNA में हमने आपको बताया डीऑक्सी राइबोज sugar है और RNA में राइबोज sugar है. तो राइबोज sugar में एक extra OH group होता है, hydroxyl group होता है 2 carbon atom में, जिसके वजह से वो ज्यादा reactive होता है. जितना functional group ज्यादा होगा किसी compound में, किसी molecule में, वो उतना reactive होगा. तो RNA में extra OH group होता है, इसलिए वो ज्यादा reactive होता है. Whereas DNA में ये ग्रुप नहीं होता, इसलिए ये स्टेबल होता है. ओके, सो बिसाइड्स दैट द DNA इज केमिकली लेस रिएक्टिव एंड स्ट्रक्चरली मोर स्टेबल व्हेन कंपेयर्ड टू RNA. एंड बिसाइड्स दैट द थायमीन आल्सो कन्फर्स एडिशनल स्टेबिलिटी टू DNA. DNA में थायमीन है लेकिन RNA में यूरासिल है. सो थायमीन में जो एक्स्ट्रा मिथाइल ग्रुप होता है, that provides extra stability to DNA. Okay, so because of the stability, extra stability of the DNA, in most of the case or predominantly DNA is the genetic material and only in few cases RNA is the genetic material. And both RNA and DNA are able to mutate. The third criteria, that is they should undergo slow mutation. But because DNA is more stable, so it undergoes slow mutation. But RNA is reactive, it is not stable like DNA. So it is the DNA is predominantly the genetic material. Both RNA and DNA are able to mutate, but RNA mutates faster. And it has shorter lifespan and evolves fast. DNA is dependent on RNA for protein synthesis, but RNA can directly form the protein. But the both can express themselves as the genetic material of a Mendel. Okay. So why is the most favorable molecule for genetic material? Why DNA? Because DNA is more stable. Now, why DNA is more stable? It is often asked in the exam. It is due to absence of hydroxyl group at 2 prime position of pentose sugar makes it less reactive. Double stranded structure of DNA provides extra strength to DNA molecule as the two strands are held by hydrogen bonds. Presence of thymine instead of uracil is another reason, and no catalytic role is exhibited by DNA. No catalytic role is exhibited by DNA. That means catalytic means kya hai? RNA can act as enzyme, but DNA can never act as enzyme. Okay? So that's why the DNA is more. This is because the DNA is more stable. Now let us study the difference between the DNA and RNA. DNA, as you know the full form, it has a deoxyribose sugar and it has a ribose sugar. That means at the 2 prime end there is a OH group. Okay, so it is unstable. And in both cases phosphate is there. Regarding the nitrogenous base, in DNA, adenine, guanine, cytosine and thymine are present. But in RNA, adenine, guanine, cytosine and uracil are present. And uracil is less stable, but thymine is more stable. DNA can replicate, RNA can also replicate. DNA is double stranded, hence more stable, but RNA is single stranded, hence less stable. And DNA shows no catalytic role and RNA shows catalytic role. Okay, so from this it is clear that DNA is very very stable than RNA. So DNA is the predominantly the genetic material in most of the organisms. Okay, so let us recapitulate what we have studied so far. The structure of DNA was done after the X-ray diffraction image of Rosalind Franklin, which was studied and analyzed by Watson and Crick. DNA consists of 2 polynucleotide strands coiled in helical fashion with unique base pairing mechanism. Each nucleotide consists of deoxyribose sugar, a 5-carbon sugar, phosphate, and a nitrogenous base. Nitrogenous base are of 4 different types, that is adenine, thymine, guanine, cytosine, classified under 2 categories, that is purine and pyrimidine. Adenine and guanine are purine, whereas thymine, cytosine are the pyrimidine. A always pairs with C, G always pairs with C, and the number of hydrogen bonds are also constant. And in between A and T, 2 hydrogen bonds are there. And in between G and C, 3 hydrogen bonds are there. And you know that hydrogen bonds are very weak bond. Okay. And we also studied the packaging of DNA in the form of nucleosome. Okay. That's all for this session. Now, in our next session, we'll discuss DNA replication. Okay. So, thank you for watching. Thank you.